Hello, I'm Elvira Green, and I'm a North Carolinian by birth. I have been a part of all things opera from 4 years old, when my mother explained to people why I was always singing, because she had already decided I was going to be an opera singer. And one day my daughter is going to sing at the Metropolitan Opera. Well, the road finally led there, but on its way, I met some incredible people that brought me to, specifically, Boston. So I look at the 50th anniversary of African Americans in opera. A beautiful occasion in Boston, where I was privileged to sit in a room with Sylvia Olden Lee commanding the orchestra with her 10 fingers, playing for everybody. And the most poignant moment for me was to hear her play Eritu for Robert McFerrin 6 months after his illness, and looked around and every male in that room sobbed. Let me understand what it was that he had done in his life that had so encouraged our African American men. That in itself started the rest of my artistic journey of dealing, teaching, mentoring, nurturing our preteen, young teen men and women in the world of opera, in the world of classical music, in the world of the Negro spiritual, in the world of the African American art songs, and how to traverse that entire musical realm so that it all belongs to all of us. My connection presently with NOA is through my artistic director and general manager, David Holly, who's one of the former presidents of NOA, who happens now to be that general manager of the Greensboro Opera Company, of which I am a member of that board, and we're getting ready to open our Performing Arts Center in Greensboro with a production of Porgy and Bess, of which I am artistic advisor. But all of this brings me today from the moment Mrs. Sylvia Olden Lee called me and I was on tour in Europe. And as Sylvia would say, get yourself here. She doesn't say, where are you? She says, get yourself here. So I flew over from someplace in Europe, and not only did I have an incredible experience sitting in the room, but I got to help set up the table for the feast. And that pleased me so, because of all the people that were doing all the things, my grandmother always said, when I find myself in a situation, help. That's all she would ever say. So that, there was so much about that occasion that has ministered to my music at this stage of my young life. So I'm extremely happy to be in this era, to have experienced especially that wonderful occasion. So that now I am part of, and I am accepting that I am part of, the colleagues of the renown. Names I won't call because you have them all. They're in the program. But that's how I have cherished that experience all those years.